Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how to enable editing options in the Syncfusion Blazor TreeGrid. You will also see the different editing modes, editing types, and how to set custom editor components and command columns in the TreeGrid. Let's start with the coding part. I will open my existing Blazor WebAssembly app, which already has the Syncfusion Blazor TreeGrid package installed. On the index.razor page, I have included the basic TreeGrid rendering code. If you want to learn how to create a basic Blazor WebAssembly app and add a Syncfusion component, please refer to the video linked in the card above or in the description below. You can visualize task details in a TreeGrid with this code. Let me run this application to show the TreeGrid. Look here, the TreeGrid is displayed with the hierarchical data. First, I'll show you how to enable editing options in the TreeGrid. By default, the TreeGrid supports options to add, delete, and update records. To perform these operations, I need to define the isPrimaryKey property as true in the task ID column, as I'm going to maintain this column with unique values. Then, I include the TreeGrid edit settings tag inside the Blazor TreeGrid tag. I'll enable the allow adding, allow editing, and allow deleting properties to perform the add, edit, and delete operations. Then, to display these editing options in a toolbar, I add the toolbar property in the TreeGrid component tag and assign the list of string values, add, edit, delete, update, and cancel. As you can see, the TreeGrid is enabled with a toolbar with edit options. You can add a new record with the add button, and edit a record by double-clicking its row. Delete a record using the delete button. From these actions, you know that the edit mode is cell. I will explain the other edit modes later in this video. Let's see the different cell edit types available in the TreeGrid component: numeric text box, drop-down list, checkbox, date picker, date time picker. By default, TreeGrid sets the edit type based on the column data type. Here, when I edit a record, you'll notice the text box is enabled for task name and priority columns, date picker is enabled for start date column, numeric text box is enabled for duration and progress columns. I can also change the built-in edit type for a TreeGrid column using the edit type property. Here, I'm going to display a drop-down list for the priority column, so let me define the edit type property and set its value to drop-down edit. Look at the output now. When I double-click on the record, you can see the drop-down editor for the priority column. Next, I am going to customize the default date picker component in the TreeGrid edit form using the DateEditSelperums class. I can customize the date picker component with the properties CSS class, enable RTL, read only, and show clear button. Let me show you how to enable the clear button in date picker. First, I include the Syncfusion Blazor calendar's namespace. Inside the @code directive, I declare the public variable DateEditParams of type DateEditSelperums. Then, I create an instance of DateEditSelperums and define the field params. Using the instance of date picker model, I define the show clear button property and set its value to true. Then I assign this variable to the editor settings option of the start date column. When I double click the records, you can see the clear button shown in date picker for the start date column. You can also set custom editor components in TreeGrid columns by using the edit template tag. I will show you how to display an autocomplete component in a task name column. To work with the Syncfusion autocomplete component, first I need to use the namespace Syncfusion Blazor dropdowns package. Then, within this task name column, I will add the edit template tag and include the tag sfautocomplete. Next, I'll define the data source property and set its value as tree data. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the autocomplete component. Therefore, I need to define the autocomplete field settings tag and map the field task name to the value property. For this autocomplete component, I need to specify the data source type, so let me define a property titem and set its value as business object. Then, I need to specify the autocomplete value field type, so I'll set tValue as a string. Also, I need to define the atBindValue property with the value task name to support two-way binding across the Blazor TreeGrid and autocomplete components. So here, you can see the TreeGrid component, and when I double-click on the record, the task name column is displayed with the autocomplete editor. Next, let me show you the different types of editing modes in the TreeGrid: cell, row, dialog, and batch. Cell editing mode is the default mode. Next, I will demonstrate the row editing mode. To enable it, I need to define the mode property inside the TreeGrid edit settings and set its value to row. Edit mode property exists in both grid and TreeGrid. So, I use the edit mode option from the TreeGrid and set its mode as row. Check the TreeGrid. To edit a row, I select a row and click the edit button. To enable the dialog edit mode, I need to change the mode property value to dialog. Look at the output page now. When I start to edit the record, the dialog pops out. I edit the existing TreeGrid fields and save the changes by clicking the Save button or discard them by clicking Cancel. Batch editing mode comes in when I want to edit multiple records at a time. To enable it, I need to change the mode property value to batch inside the TreeGrid edit settings. See the output now. I can edit multiple TreeGrid records by double-clicking the cells, and the modified records will be highlighted. I update those records on a single request by clicking the Update button in the toolbar. Finally, I will show you how to add command columns in a TreeGrid. The command column provides an option to add CRUD action buttons to a column. The built-in command buttons are edit, delete, save, and cancel. I include the TreeGrid column with manage records as the header text and 140 as the width. Then, I include TreeGrid command columns to include these command buttons. First, I add single command button using TreeGrid command column and set the type as edit. I include the button option and set its icon using the icon CSS property. In the same way, I include another column for delete command. And then I change the mode property value to row. Check the TreeGrid. The manage records column has edit and delete command buttons. Let me quickly summarize what we have seen in this video. I showed you how to enable editing options in the Syncfusion Blazor TreeGrid. Also, we saw the different editing modes, editing types, and how to set custom editor components and command columns in the TreeGrid. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.